Hello friends, in this video, I'm going to explain the implementation of pre-decrement and post-decrement operator. Okay, so let's see how it is working. So I'm writing a program where I will show you the use of pre-increment and pre-decrement and post-decrement operator. So let's see. Here I'm writing has include stdio.h, then void main opening curly bracket, then closing curly bracket. So I'm writing three variables, int x, I'm assigning a value 10 to it, then y, then z. Okay, I've declared three variables, x, y, z. X contains 10 and two variables are y and z. In the next statement, I'm writing x minus minus. This is post decrement. This is comment line, double slash. This is comment line, and this sentence or this statement says about post decrement operation. So x, first variable, then operator. So post, after the variable, that's why it is called as post decrement. So now I am using printf statement to display the value of y. Y is equal to percentile d, comma, y, semicolon. Next, printf, within double quotation, x equal to percentile d, comma, x, semicolon. So this sentence will show you the value of y, and this will show you the value of x. So again, in the next statement, I am writing z is equal to minus minus x semicolon. This is pre-decrement. This shows the operation of pre-decrement operator. Why it is called pre-decrement? Because this operator is used before the variable, before the operand. That's why it is called pre-decrement operator. So now I am again using printf function, printf, to display the value of z. Suppose I'm writing slash n here. Here I'm also using slash n or new line to represent the display new line. Slash n z equal to percentile d, double quotation end z. The value of z will be displayed here. Again, in the next statement, I'm using printf function and then double quotation start slash n. X is equal to percentile d, double quotation end x. The value of x will be displayed here. It will show you the value of z and it will show you the value of x. So here x is a variable, x contains 10. Then y is another variable and z is another variable. So when this statement will be executed, it will show you that y equal to x minus minus. It means here, first the value of x will be assigned to y, then the value of x will be decremented. So it means what will be the value of y? The value of y will be 10, okay? Then the x value will be decremented. So x will be decremented by 1 and it will be 9. So this statement will print the value of y as 10 and this will print the value of x as 9. So again, z is equal to minus minus x. That means pre-decrement operator. So here, the value of x is 9. And this statement says, first, the value will be decremented. Then after the value will be assigned to Z. First it will be decremented, this operation will be done. Then after the value will be assigned to Z. So now X will be decremented by 1, that will be 8. And this 8 will be assigned to Z. That means the value of Z will be 8. So this statement will print 8 and this statement will print 8. Okay. So let's see. And I'm writing the program, writing the same program in Dev C++ editor. Let's see how it is working. Here I'm opening my Dev C++ editor. So here I'm going to file, then new. Then from the new, I'm choosing source file. Okay. So now I'm writing the program as include stdio.h. Next, void main opening curly bracket, closing curly bracket. Int x is equal to 10 semicolon, comma, y, comma, z, then semicolon. The next statement I'm writing x equal to x, y is equal to x minus minus semicolon. Then using printf statement, I want to display the value of y. Y is equal to percentile d, then comma, y, semicolon. Next, I want to display the value of x. So for that, I'm using a slash n operator. X is equal to percentile d, comma, x, semicolon. Okay. So again, in the next statement, I'm using z is equal to minus minus x, semicolon. And similarly, I'm using printf function to display the value of z. For that, I'm using slash n. Then z is equal to percentile d, then comma, z, okay, semicolon. Next, in the next statement, I'm again using printf statement to represent the value of x. It's less than x is equal to percentile d, double quotation end, comma, x. Right parenthesis and then semicolon. Okay. Now my program is complete. Let's compile the program and see the output. So I'm giving the name as decrement. Decrement. And the source file will be .c. Source files with the extension .c. Save. Okay, here some error is showing. Here the right parenthesis is missing. That's why the error was showing. So now this is correct. So let's once again compile it. Here the compilation is complete. The errors are zero. Warnings are zero. That means my program is correct. So now let's execute it. Here you can see the execution value of y is first 10. Then x is 9. Then after pre-increment, the value of z is 8 and x is 8. Okay. Similarly, you can do it for taking other variables or other values. So let's see. I'm changing the value of 10. Suppose I'm changing the value of 10 to, suppose I'm taking it 100. Once again, yes, you can see the value of y first will be 100, then x will be decremented, that is post decrement, and x will, the value of x will be 99. Then z is equal to minus minus x, that means pre increment. So first x value will be decremented, then it will be assigned to z. So x value will be decremented and the value will be 98 and that will be assigned to z. So z is equal to 98. And finally, x equal to 98. So in this way, we can use the decrement, post-decrement and pre-decrement operators. Okay. So thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel and share it with your friends. Thank you for watching.